That picture is something I'm going to cherish forever.
Ian's here with me now. We've got 9 pictures, 7 golf, 1 F1 and 1 football, 2 sports close to Ian's heart when he's not on the course. And we're just going to have a little quick chat about all of them. First one I've got here was back in the year 2000, Italian Open, your first win on the European Tour.
Absolutely.
What's your feelings looking back on this?
You know, I remember it very well. Pleated trousers, baggy shirt, but you know, for me, to be able to win in Italy, to win Rookie of the Year, to win my first European Tour event at the end of my first season was, you know, super, super special. You know, I mean, I even have that putter still in my office. So I remember it like it was yesterday. And to think, you know, we're now 22 years on from there. And, you know, it was a great week. I remember it very well, hitting 6-iron into the last. And obviously, you know, getting the job done.
Yeah, and you
was amazing.
You still had the sideburns at the time as well.
I still had the sideburns. Yeah, we've changed them up now. We've got a little bit more grey and a little bit more facial hair. But I mean, it was. You could see how much it meant back then.
Yeah.
You know, to win a tournament, to win Rookie of the Year, to get the job done, to really kind of, you know, put my foot, you know, firmly through the door to say, you know, I'm a European Tour winner.
And back by
some.
And some strong early season form as well. I think second in Morocco, you came close in Morocco, third in Sao Paulo as well.
I did. Morocco was a good finish. And, you know, if I think back to then, you know, I had my old caddy back then. Unfortunately, he passed away last week. So that was sad. But I remember, you know, even back then enjoying my time on the course with him in Morocco. And time flies. It really does. It's incredible.
And time flies as well because 12 years on, and 12 worldwide wins later, we're in Medina, the miracle of Medina. What a picture.
Yes, great picture. Medina is something that's going to stay with me for a very long time. And, you know, this picture was obviously, you know, Sunday afternoon once we got the job done. But, you know, I still have today, I have the outfit from Saturday's round of golf in my office.
Class.
It's on a mannequin. It means so much to me. I think from a perspective of being part of the team, being 6 points behind, deep into Saturday's afternoon round, Sergio and Luke turning their match around into a point to be 10-5, and obviously Rory and I, you know, turn that last match on Saturday afternoon around to give us the opportunity to go out on Sunday to be able to enjoy this moment. Very special.
Flawless weekend for you as well because you won all 4 matches.
Yeah, it was a magic week. Yeah. It really was. I mean, I love my team sport.
Yeah.
This being one of them, and you know, Medina's going to be, you know, it's going to be in the record books for a long time.
What were the celebrations like that night?
They were pretty strong.
Yeah.
I have to say. Yeah, there was a hangover the following day.
You had a good technique with the glass, did you?
It was a good time.
And then 2 months later, Ian, you continued your great form. We're over in China here now. WGC, HSBC champions in contention going into the final day, 4 shots behind. Like, what was your kind of talking to yourself that morning when you arrived at the course?
He was obviously a strong field,
yeah.
WGC, and you know, for me to, you know, like the golf course we play, the Elazabal course, and you know, a lot of good players in contention. Mickelson was right there.
Duffner, wasn't he?
Duffner was up there.
Jason and Day, I think.
Yeah, and I just remember, you know, coming into that final round, knowing I was a few shots behind, just trying to be super aggressive, trying to take the opportunities that I had, and obviously, you know, making up and down on the last to grab my hands on a, you know, another WGC was absolutely magic.
8 birdies in the first 15 holes as well, that's some start.
You remember it, obviously, you've done your homework, so I didn't realise there was 8 birdies. Yeah, it was a lot.
Yeah.
Oh man, I know it was a lot, and I obviously posted a good number and good enough to obviously win.
Class. Then 6 years on, love this picture as well. I remember watching it in the office one morning just with the time difference over in Houston, April 2018. What a picture. I think that was after the 20-foot birdie that forced into the playoff. 5 beats the chest as well. What a moment.
Was it 5?
Yeah.
It's still bruised today.
Is it, yeah? You're still walking fine there.
You know, so much significance on winning that week.
Yeah.
I thought I'd done enough to make it in the Masters. Technically, I hadn't. You know, I come up just a tiny bit short, and then obviously having to go to Houston, didn't have a very good first round. I was lying probably 108th. And it's amazing the power of the mind sometimes to be able to focus, to get a job done. And obviously that putt to get into the playoff was a huge putt, 25 feet I think it was. And obviously to get it done in the playoff, to get back in the winner's circle, to get to Augusta, and obviously, you know, have the opportunity there to enjoy another great week.
What was that feeling like?
It was magic. I mean, you could, you know, it'd been a long time between wins. Yeah. And I think you could see that emotion
absolutely
come out of me on the last hole.
And then 5 months later, what a picture. Le Golf National. I've got two. We'll go into this one in a second. Over in Paris.
Yes.
Love this.
There was a great group of guys that followed me around all week, and they wore a postman outfit. And, you know, the guys, one of the caddies called me the postman a few years ago, a Celtic manor, when I said I would deliver a point. So because of the delivery, they decided to call me the postman. And obviously, you know, we got some fantastic fans in Europe, and they all pitched up in, you know, I think there was about six of them in these post box.
Really?
And, you know, when I finished on 18 and, you know, the whole celebrations were going, they were right there at the front of the crowd. So I asked one of them if I could take his post box and proceeded to put it on and have a bit of fun.
Class. I mean, you can't beat winning as a team, but when you have family around to taste success as well, it makes it even more better. I remember seeing this picture as well in the paper a day after and looking at it again over the weekend, and that's class. Like, that's something your son's going to look at for the rest of his life and cherish that. It's an amazing picture.
Yeah, it's always difficult talking about it because you get very emotional about the time you have with your kids.
Yeah.
This is probably one of the proudest moments I've ever had on a golf course. You know, it meant a lot to him, and it meant even more to me. To spend a little bit of that time, you know, bonding with your kids is very special. So, you know, that picture is something I'm going to cherish forever. It means the world to me, and, you know, hopefully there's a lot of, you know, learning exercises in there. And it's just, it's special. Family time's always special.
That's a cracking
picture. It's probably the best picture I have at home right now.
Brilliant. And with it being a Ryder Cup year, I think this one could be from 2015, Whistling Straits. How good would it be to be going back there with the European Ryder Cup team, going for a sixth win for you in seven appearances, which is an amazing record?
Yeah, it would be amazing to, you know, to play again. And, you know, there's a lot of focus on this year to up my game.
Yeah.
I think I've definitely got the opportunity. I definitely think I've got the game. It would please me no end to obviously play another Ryder Cup. And if that is the case and we can put our hands back on that trophy again, it would mean an awful lot to be able to do that.
Absolutely. Love to see you back there as well. And away from the golf, me and you are two big F1 fans.
Yeah.
I've got the Ferrari shoes on here now. I know you're a big Ferrari fan too. What success is this man, Charles Leclerc, going to bring our sport over the next decade?
It's in good hands. I mean, as somebody as young as he, you know, when you think about the quality of driver that he's turned out to be very quickly, to have as many pole positions as he had.
Seven last season.
Seven, which was absolutely remarkable.
Yeah.
You know, at such an early age to be that good is mind-blowing. So to see him in a red car is kind of incredible. To see the healthy rivalry that's there in F1 right now, it's going to be really exciting, you know, not only this year, but obviously for years to come.
Which race are you going to get to this season?
Not sure yet. I'd like to get to a couple if I can.
The Dutch one looks class.
It looks amazing.
It looks amazing. That circuit looks unreal.
It's all on the schedule. All on the schedule.
Hopefully you get there. And then football, both of us Arsenal fans, plenty of times over the years as well, I'm getting abuse from all my friends and even colleagues about being a Gunner fan, but I firmly believe this man, Mikel Arteta, is going to get us playing that attacking brand of football that we crave. Maybe not this season, but it will happen.
I think, you know, when you look at the football Arsenal have played through the years, again, they've played great football. Already since he's been at the club, there's a different energy about the players. The formation looked a little cleaner.
Yeah.
Yes, he's probably going to need to bring some other players in to strengthen the squad. But I mean, I'm excited. I mean, he's learned from one of the best managers ever in football. So it's exciting times ahead. As an Arsenal fan, we can only look to improve from the position we're in today. And hopefully he's the man to take us there.
Tenth in the table now, maybe prediction for the season, seventh?
You, obviously move forward from where we are right now, but I think more importantly, if there's some confidence in the team,
yeah.
if there is some funds there for him to strengthen the side,
yeah.
to build. I mean, we obviously can't do an awful lot from the position we're in this year, so you just have to look forward to obviously next year and see what he can do.
Absolutely. And just finally, in the clinic today, how did you find that?
It was great. You know, any time where I get to be able to spend some time with juniors and kids in the game of golf, special for me. I remember my time in the pro shop, you know, teaching kids how to play golf, and it's just wonderful to be able to spend some time to try and give them some tips, to see the enjoyment that they get in the game of golf, and enjoy the game that obviously I grew up loving as well.
Absolutely. Listen, really appreciate your time. Thanks so much.